Welcome to Learn Python with Castor Classes. So today we are just getting into the loops. Okay, so loops are something which is similar to this in the Scratch. Okay, so let us just do it in the animated way. Let us understand the concept and then we'll go for the Python side. Okay, so we are just first going to see about this if loop. Okay, so if okay you have a diamond shape here, then and there is a space here, so you can just put something here, like I say if okay, if I'll put a condition which just fits here, and I'll make it to, so instead of this I'll just go for looks. Okay, so I say the cat to say hello for 2 seconds, and now I just go take the put it in the diamond shape. Okay, so here in the diamond shape, if you put some block, they are called test expression. Okay, so you give some expression. So that text expression is checked. If the text expression is true, then this is executed. If the test expression is false, then nothing will happen. Okay, in if then. Okay, so now see here, I'm just going to take this touching mouse pointer. So what happens? So I also join this with the when flag click. Okay, and forever. So what happens is when I just click the flag, it just keep on working. So if I touch the cat, it says hello. If I take the take it after 2 seconds, it just it will not say anything. Okay, if I go again touch the cat, it say hello. If I just take it off, it will not say. Okay, so let us change the color on those. So I'll just change the color by 25. So for each touch, it change the color. So let me just stop it. Okay, what it does is it says hello for 2 seconds and it changes the color. Okay, so again it says hello and change the color. Okay, so this is what happens. If the text expression here, okay, the touching mouse pointer is passed, then it does say hello for 2 seconds and change the color by 25. This is what the if loop is. Okay, so you have a text expression. If it is true, it just go and executes the command. Now I'm just going to take you to this area where I have written some syntax for if. Okay, so see here, if text expression is if text expression colon, this is the syntax, and just give enter. So don't do any change after pressing the enter, okay, because some indenting problem will come, and then you can just type in the statement to execute when it is true. That is what it should do when the text expression is true. Okay, so suppose see here, I'm just going to this. Okay, so num is equal to input. Okay, so I'm just giving input of, okay, like I'm just checking into int also. Okay, int of input of. Okay, so please enter a number, that is what I give. Okay, so this is I give and close it, and then what I do is if num, okay, so greater than 0, I just check if num greater than 0, colon you have to give, just press enter and print the given number is positive. Okay, so this is what I give. Okay, and that's it. Okay, I save it. You don't have to give end as like other things. Okay, so go to the document and go to the, I mean, this is how I save it. Go, oh my god, my Scratch gone to this. That's okay. So I go for if condition. Okay, if condition 1, save. Now if I go run the module, so it asks me enter the number, I give -7, it doesn't do anything. Now I again go run the module, so I give just 7, so the number is positive. Okay, so just see here, the same thing, as we touch the cat, it changes the color. First it says hello and change the color. So here the text expression is, if it is greater than 0, then it says yes, the number is positive. Okay, so this is what the text expression. And now let us see, I'll just put this block here and I go take if else. Okay, if then else, same touch expression I'm just going, text expression I'm giving, that is touching mouse pointer. So if it touches the mouse pointer, I say hello for 2 seconds and change the color. Okay, and then if it is not, then what I do, I just make it to, yeah, I'll just make it to go to the random position. No, So let's make it play sound meow. Okay, so this is what I'm going to do. So I'll just instead of I'll do this way. Okay, like I'll put meow when it is true, and if it is not touching, it says hello and change the colors. So it says hello and change the colors often. If I go tap, it says meow. Okay, can you hear the meow sound? Yes, it changed the meow. Okay. So now what happens is, if the text expression is true, okay, if the text expression is true, here this is what done, play sound meow will done. And if it is not true, if it is false, then this is what done. Okay. So now let us go see the syntax of it. So the syntax is, if text expression, the statements to execute when it is true, else statements to execute when it is false. Okay. So what it happens when it is true, it says meow. And when it was false, it said hello and what it said, hello and change the color. Okay, so this is what we are going to do. Let us see how it works. Okay, so I'm just going to just extend the program. Okay, so just enter elif, okay, colon, print, okay, print the given number. Okay, given number is negative. Okay, so this is what I do, save it. Run it for any error. Yeah, we have error. So it's elif. Okay, so elif, I didn't give the condition. Okay, so sorry. So it should be else. Okay, so else, now it will be fine. Now I run it. So yeah, there I have some error. So it has to be yes, indenting problem. That is what there in the Python. Okay, so it has to be here. This is the way it has to be. Now I run it. It asks me to enter the number. I just give -7. So if it is, this is false. Okay. The condition is false. That is, number is not greater than 0. So the second condition, that is the given second expression, that is the given number is negative, is printed. So if I go again, run it. It asks me the number. I give 5. The condition is true. That is, the number is greater than 0. And it prints, yes, the number is positive. Okay. So this is what if and if else. And you know, so text expression if elif, okay, suppose you have so many conditions, like the text expression 1, text expression 2, text expression 3. If you want to check if it passes any of this text expression, like if it passes the text expression 1, this statement is executed. If it passes the text expression 2, it just execute this statement. Okay, if it is not passing the both the text expression, then this statement is executed. Okay, so this is what if elif else. Okay, so I go here directly to the Python and do the changes in the code. So here what I do is, I say elif, okay, and here you have to give the expression also. Elif means you have to give the expression. So num, yeah, you're going to check num is equal to 0. Okay, equal to 0. If it is equal to 0, the given number is 0, you have to give. Okay, so given number is 0, else. Okay, so you can just go do else and print the given number is positive. Okay, the given number is positive. Okay, positive. So this is what I give. I save it. I run it. So yeah, that is an error. So I haven't given the colon. Okay. So now everything should be fine. So I give 0. So 0. Now see here. So this num is equal to 0. So the elif, the second test expression, is passed. Okay. So the given number is 0. Okay. So if suppose I again run it. Okay. So I again run it, and suppose I give 9. Okay, sorry, it should be the negative, right? So yes, so it should be negative. Okay, so I run. Now I run it and I give -9. Okay, so -9. The -9 is not greater than 0. So the first text expression, that is the given number is positive, will not work and will not print it. And num is equal to 0. I just check whether the given number is equal to 0. No, it is not. -9 is not equal to 0. So this expression will also not print it. Finally, if both the expression fail, then this expression will print it. That is, the given number is negative. Let us check. Yes? Yes. So this is what if, elif, and else. If, else, if. Okay. So we have seen these three loops today. That is branching if, Okay, so here you have to just be very careful with the indenting problem, this colon. Okay, so you have seen, even I have done mistake. So you can also be very careful while just doing this. Okay, and that's all for today's video. We'll meet you in the next video with another interesting loop. Okay, till then, take care. Bye bye.